Hey everyone, I'm Richard Fang. Today we're going to be teaching you about the basics of jazz. Jazz is personally one of my favorite music genres just because it's much more casual than, say, things like classical or romantic music, and it harbors a lot of creativity with the aspect of improv, which is basically making up a solo on the spot instead of like looking at a sheet of music to play a solo. And there's a really cool aspect of jazz where you can play literally anything with everything. So say if I want to pick up my B-flat clarinet, or my acoustic guitar, and I wanted to play an improv solo, I could do that. And that's a really good aspect of jazz. But let's move aside and talk about the instrumentation of a big jazz band. There are two sections in a jazz band, but first I'm going to go over probably the most important one, which is the rhythmic section. The rhythmic section is composed of four instruments, which is the drums, the piano, the guitar, and the bass. First, I'm going to go over the drums. The drums are regarded as the heart of a jazz band because they keep time and they keep rhythm using their bass drum and hi-hat. They also have a snare, a ride cymbal, a crash cymbal, and three toms. The reason why the drum is regarded as the heart of a jazz band is because we don't really have a conductor. The conductor sure counts us off, but when we're actually playing, we listen back to the drums. We don't actually have someone giving us the counts for the beats, we just have to listen for them. Next, I'm going to be talking about the chordal instruments, or the piano and the guitar. Sometimes you're going to be finding these as electric, but you can find these as acoustic as well. Now, the piano and the guitar give us a chord outline and harmonic context using syncopated or sustained rhythms. Finally, I'm going to be talking about the bass. You can find this also in the form of a bass guitar, and you can also find this as electric or acoustic. The bass plays alongside the drums, which means that they also give us a sense of rhythm by playing the roots of every chord. Or they can be doing a thing what we like to call in jazz a walking bass line, which is kind of a linear way of approaching a chord progression. In a jazz band, you're going to be finding these four instruments sitting decently close to each other because they all do effectively the same job, which is keeping time and giving us chords. But next, we're going to be moving on to the horn section. The horn section is what actually plays the harmonic and melodic lines of music. Usually you're going to find these in three rows. In the first row, you're going to be finding alto sax, tenor sax, and bari sax. In the second row, you're going to be finding a tenor trombone, and sometimes a bass trombone. And in the third row, you're going to be finding B-flat trumpets. Finally, we are going to get to the auxiliary instruments. These instruments may include a B-flat clarinet, C flute, a flugelhorn, etc. Now, remember that these lists of instruments aren't strictly all of them. Really, as I said before, jazz is whatever you make it, and you can play anything with everything. And next, I'm going to hand it off to Zach to teach you style.
Next, one of the most unique things about jazz is its stylistic differences as compared to classical. One of these stylistic changes is swinging, in which you play a longer first note followed by a shorter second note. One of the ways you can quantify swinging is by splitting up a single beat into three sections into triplets and taking the first two triplets and making them the long note and making the third triplet the shorter note. For example, what would sound like this in classical music? Would sound like this in jazz. Also, you'll notice that the faster something is, the straighter it sounds. For example, something fast like this is a lot less swung than something slower like this. Another stylistic change in jazz is the articulation of notes. For example, for shorter notes such as staccatos, marcatos, and accents, you want to end the notes with your tongue to make them short and crisp. Also, for accents and marcatos, you want to have more punch at the beginning of the notes. All in all, those are some of the stylistic aspects of jazz, and I hope you enjoyed and learned something. Be sure to subscribe to Harmonies from Home and stay tuned for more content. Peace.